tone, telling your story about how you've been raped. Man, how you gonna do that?
Yeah, man, living in Compton has really molded me to be the person that I am today. I gotta give it all the props, man. It taught me how to, you know, have thick skin. It created me to be one of the best networkers in the world, in my opinion.
Back then, man, it was real wicked, man. You know what I'm saying? We was out here doing our thing, man. You know, playing gunplay shit wasn't no joke, homie. You know, I lost homies to this shit, man. Once my brother got murdered in 95, homie, it was just crazy, man. Nigga lost all kind of respect for a whole lot of people, man. And, you know, fuck my little despot, my little homeboy Desperado from Trailer Park, man. Back in the day, my nigga just lost it, homie, and he went on a mission, man, and fucked around. He lost his life at a young age, man, like 21 years old, man, you know, but,
And I was attacked by one of the homies in the neighborhood trying to get me up to the middle school where they would take all their victims and rape them and kill them and all kind of stuff was going on. They was raping women and faking houses and, I mean, I've seen a lot, I heard a lot, stuff that a 15-year-old girl shouldn't have been even around.
Yeah, you know, after they let me go back in 98, you know, I done them 3 years, man, I jumped from negative to positive, man, I had to because, you know, being two strikes, you know what I'm saying, and fucking with the system, man, you can't win, man, they can get you.
You know, I know a lot of people think that Compton is negative. They hear about all the gangs and all the killings and all the so-called drug dealings in the city of Compton. Well, I'm not saying that probably didn't go on in the city.
The night that I got raped by one of the homies in the neighborhood, and they pulled into a motel, and I didn't want to go. And I was telling them I don't want to go, and they kept trying to reassure me that
everything was going to be cool.
But I knew what I was getting myself into once we put up in that motel.
I remember coming up in Compton. My mom was dating this guy. He moved us in a blood neighborhood, but he was a Crip. And him and his Crip homies used to hang out in the front yard. One night they left. They shot our house up so bad. Man, I almost lost my life.
One time I sold my product and it didn't have everything it was supposed to have in it. And they came back for me. And they came back with a vengeance. They came with guns and they kicked in the door where we were staying at. And they was like, they wanted their money back. And I'm like, I don't have your money. If you're gonna kill me, just do what you gotta do because I don't have your money and I don't have no more product.
I remember walking home from Compton High. I lived in Sunny Cove. Bitches in Wilmington Arms, which was across the street from Sunny Cove, straight jumped me. Scandalous ass bitches.
The rape. Honestly, we was going on our way. We was doing a dope deal. We were supposed to do an exchange where, you know, money for what we were selling. And instead of the guys focusing on that, they chose to take advantage of me. And I started begging and pleading, like, take all the money, take everything I have, please don't do this to me. And the first person done it, and as he was doing it, I just started calling out to Jesus and asking Jesus, please, to save me. And then the second person got ready to rape me. And when he got on top of me and spread my legs open, he got up and said, this bitch keep calling for Jesus.